Hey guys, so it's another tutorial. So as you can tell, the front is 15 and the back is 2 inches longer than the front. So I'm gonna take the front aside and I am going to fold the extra 2 inches and pin it down. So once you're done with that, place the front on the back, and from the waist to the hip is 9 inches, so I'm just gonna mark that. So now I'm gonna take the measurement for the waist. So whatever measurement you're using, divide it by 4 and add 2 inches to it for the seam allowance and that. So I'm using 32 inches, and I believe 32 divided by 4 is 8, so I marked 8 and I added 2 inches to it. And I am using 43 for the waist measurement, for the hip I mean, and I divided that by 4 and I added 2 inches to it. And so whatever measurement that I got for the hip, I am going to take 2 inches from it and I am going to mark the bottom. So in total I got 13, so I'm gonna take 2 inches of it, and I got 11, and I'm gonna mark it at the bottom. So once that is done, I'm gonna fold it aside and go ahead and cut the lining for it. So I'm gonna separate the back piece now and take the pins out and cut the lining for it. I'm gonna cut the lining as well. And I'm gonna take the 1/2 inch from the bottom, like I did for the front. So I went ahead and sewed, but you guys remember we took 1/2 inch from the lining, so that is why you can see the fabric is longer than the lining. So we're just gonna pull it up to meet the fabric. This is for the seam allowance. Most people leave like 1 or 2 inches, but I just prefer, I mean, what's the point of leaving that big? It's just a waste of fabric for me. So I just,
take half an inch from it and I just do it.
So I'm gonna go ahead and fold the extra 2 inches that we left at the back of the skirt. I'm gonna go ahead and fold it down. So it's time for the dart, and I'm gonna mark 4 inches from the midpoint, and I'm gonna mark half an inch on each side. And I'm gonna stand on the midpoint and mark 4 inches. That will be the length of the dart. And I'm gonna do the same for the other side and for the back. So this is how you know your dart is in the correct positions. So you place a pin in, and when it appears exactly at the other point, then you know you're good. So after sewing the dart, I'm gonna go ahead and join the back pieces together. So I'm gonna leave a slit at the back, and this will help you with movements. It's gonna make it easier for you to move if you leave a slit at the back. It wouldn't be too tight on the bottom. And the length of my slit is 8 inches. You can go 4 or 5, either ways, it's up to you. I'm gonna go in for 8 inches, and I'm going to remember we're gonna put a waistband on the skirt, so I'm gonna take 2 inches off the zipper, and then I'm gonna mark so where the zipper ends. I'm gonna pin it, and then I'm gonna sew the midpoint in between those two pins. So in order to prevent the allowance from showing at the back when you are walking, you can hem it down or you can machine stitch it. But I prefer to use this method because it's easy and it works for me. So yeah. So it's all nice and clean now, so I'm gonna go ahead and pin that side closed. So after pinning it, I'm gonna mark the exact measurement for the skirt. So the waist measurement that I'm using is 32 inches, so 32 divided by 2 is 16 inches. And so I'm gonna find a midpoint and divide the 16 by 2, which is 8. And I'm gonna put the 8 on the midpoint, and I'm gonna mark the 16. And from the waist to the hip is 9 inches, so I'm gonna mark that. And the hip measurement that I'm using is 43 inches, so 43 divided by 2 is 21.5 inches. And I'm going to find the midpoint and divide that 21.5 and put whatever measurement that I get in the middle, and I'm gonna mark the 21.5 on one side, and I'm gonna mark the other side, as you can see me do. And so whatever measurement that I got for the hip, I'm gonna take 2 inches from it, and I'm gonna use that measurement for the bottom. So here I got 19 and a half inches, I believe. So yeah, I'm gonna use my shape curve to mark the shapes. So now I'm gonna pin the back and the front pieces together. Make sure you're marking the dots. That is very, very important. And both of them, make sure they are matching each other. And make sure the midpoints are meeting each other. And once you get that, you can go ahead and pin the sides. So now you can go ahead and trim off the extra excess fabric. I honestly prefer to have excess fabric than to shred off fabric. So yeah. So now you can go ahead and serge the sides. So go ahead and measure the circumference of the waist. So we're gonna cut the waistband. So guys, I'm gonna show you a method that requires no violin, because I know most people might not have it. And so I'm going to show you a method that requires no violin. So with this method, instead of cutting the 5 inches, you are going to fold the fabric on it. So you're going to fold 2 layers and you're going to mark the 5 inches for the width. And you're going to mark the waist measurement that you got when you measure the circumference of the waist. But whatever measurement you got, add 1 inch to it. So I got 35, so I added one inch to it, making it 36. And I cut it. So go ahead and press it down to remove every fold in it. And go ahead and pin it to the skirt. So I'm going to fold 1/2 inch and pin it to the skirt. So this is after I sewed the first layer to it, and I'm gonna go ahead and fold it for the waistband and pin it down.
Banana follow you, brother follow you. Cause I'm in love with you. Money fall on you. Banana fall on you. Paparazzi follow you. Cause I'm in love with you. Are you done talking? Tell me, baby, are you done talking? Yeah. Are you done talking? Tell me, baby, are you done talking? Yeah. Are you-